He must die. He must die. That's why Peter, remember Peter? When Jesus said, I have to go to Jerusalem. Oh, God forbid. You do not go to Jerusalem. They will kill you there. He couldn't see that the secret of Jesus' life was he must die. He must die. Number two, slow learners. They were indeed slow learners. And they were afraid to ask him. Sounds familiar? You know, I've been teaching for so long. I've been teaching all kinds of people, classes. Mostly adults, because I teach in college. I don't deal with teenagers and that. And even the adults, they're so ashamed, they're so afraid to ask questions, even if they don't understand. Are you like that too? Oh, you have to voice it out. There's something I don't understand. I need to understand this. The apostles were learning very slowly, and yet they were afraid to ask. They were afraid to ask. If you start with line four, learning Christ's way, see that line four, number two? Learning Christ's way requires that we in some way unlearn our own ways. We must unlearn our own ways because Jesus must increase and we must decrease. Famous word from John chapter 3 from John the Baptist. That's why no one can be neutral before Christ. Did you know that? With Jesus Christ, you can't be neutral. Oh, I have no sides. I'm not taking sides. No. With Jesus Christ, either you're for him or you're against him. Those are the only two choices we have. It's no such thing as neutral. Number three, the hardest lesson. Remember the story in Mark chapter 9, where they were walking, they were arguing who was the greatest. They were arguing who was the greatest. Imagine that. It's just like, okay, let's discuss who among us four is the best. Or who among us is the best looking. You think we can agree on that? We can agree? Probably not. Because everyone will say, I'm the best looking, I'm the best looking, I'm the best looking, I'm the best looking. That's a question that cannot be answered. And that's the hardest lesson for us. Not only do they fail to listen to Jesus, they're busy asserting their will. See that? That should be highlighted. Second line, number three. Not only do they fail to listen to Jesus, they're busy asserting their will. Wow. That's a big, big lesson for you and for me. You know, it's just like when you speak, you cannot listen. You cannot listen because you're talking, you're busy talking. So if you want to listen, if you want to hear God's voice, what do? Shut up. Shut up, don't speak, and listen. Keep quiet. Wednesday, the zeal of charity, still Mark chapter 9. Teacher, we saw someone driving out demons in your name, and we tried to prevent him because he does not follow us. Again, as I was saying, Mark chapter 9, in Jesus, there's no such thing as neutral, like Switzerland. So Switzerland is a neutral country. So everybody is a friend of Switzerland. You notice that? Now, the US is not neutral. That's why we have friends and we have enemies. And our enemies are not neutral either. But for Jesus, there's no such thing as neutral. Either you're his friend or you're his enemy. Those are the only two choices. One, a son of thunder. We try to prevent him. What do you notice here? They approach the person. Stop. Stop whatever you're doing. You cannot do this. You have to follow us. So they acted first before they consulted Jesus. That's the one big lesson here. Sounds familiar. A lot of us are like that. When we are intimidated, when we are anxious, when we are angry, before we think, we speak first. And then we feel sorry. Remember, I've been telling you, the worst time to write an email is when you're angry. That's the worst time to write an email. Because chances are, the email you'll be sending, you will regret later. Same thing here. The apostles were so zealous. They acted first before asking Jesus. And what did Jesus say? No, don't prevent him. If he's not against us, then he's for us. So, judgments of gospel charity, number two. We call that positive judgment. Either for or against him. Thursday, price of the kingdom. Whatever you and I do, we must do it in the name of Jesus. If you cook in the name of Jesus, it becomes very light. If you don't get even in the name of Jesus, that's very good. Whatever you do, do it in the name of Jesus. That's number one lesson on Thursday. Jesus leaves us with no doubt. We're valuable. We all carry within us God-given dignity. And this dignity is identified and enhanced when we bear his name. So we are priceless. Every little one is priceless. I like number three. Look at number three. In today's world, we always compare. Which one is more important? Which one is more important? To watch Dancing with the Stars? Or help with your children's homework? Go on, just do it. I'll check it later. Then you'll watch Dancing with the Stars or American Idol, depends on what night it is. Or The Bachelorette now. That's what we do in this world. Look at this. We compare our things with some at the same time, like stocks, or Apple stock, GM stock, food, clothes, music, films. They're always judged against each other. But there's something more important than this, one that has absolute value, and that is the human soul. That's the human soul. This is one point I keep stressing on my sons. The human soul. I cannot stay with you any longer. Time will come, I have to leave you. I'll be gone. But if there's anything you can remember, remember this thing. You have your own dignity as a child of God. And you have a soul that has absolute value. Absolute value is more important than anything else. That's why Jesus said, what is there to gain if you gain the whole world and lose your soul? What? There's nothing there. So it's better to lose anything else. You know, there's an old song. I don't know if you know the Seekers from Australia. They have a song, I'll Never Find Another You. But part of that song says, I could lose you, I could lose all this. Something like that. I could lose all this, but I don't care. Because as long as I have you, because I'll never find another you. Which is true. Friday, one flesh. Mark chapter 10. Is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife? This is the gospel on Sunday. This is the gospel on Sunday, Mark chapter 10. So what did Moses command you? Okay, let's see the rest. Number one. Docile or unteachable? You know what docile means? Docility. What does docile mean? Where is your docile? Where do you live? The place of docility is the place where you normally stay. And it says, they should keep their hearts open and docile. The Pharisees gather not as learners, but as those who know better. I heard that. Someone has said that to me, indirectly. Why should I go to your class? I know better. The Pharisees were like that. They were not to learn. They were saying, you have nothing to tell me that I do not already know. That's in effect what is being said. There's nothing. Absolute lack of humility. So those are unteachable, those Pharisees. From his teaching in the temple at age 12 to the present, no one has spoken like him with authority and truth. So how do we approach Jesus and his church? The authority of the church and the truth that the church teaches. Why do you think we have so many denominations? You notice that? Just try. You will see every other corner there's a, what church is that? And guess what? What in effect they're saying is, exactly. To divorce or not to divorce? Talk about Hollywood. Today I learned someone got married and they married in Las Vegas and then they, I forgot where they went for their honeymoon and they filed divorce in that place where they had supposed to be honeymoon. Number three, the flesh of God's plan. This should be highlighted, underlined. The first sentence, the flesh that God created was holy, a gift, a temple of God and destined for eternal life. You know what that is? It's our body. Our bodies. Saturday, Children of the Kingdom, Mark chapter 10. Two visions. Again, the apostles seem to be missing the point. So Jesus clearly speaks to them. We will not stop them today. Many of us also fail to understand. By our lack of understanding, we prevent children from coming to Jesus. You know what this reminds me? Those parents. Those parents of children attending catechism classes, when they get the first communion, the parents are instrumental for them not to come to Mass. Right here. Mark chapter 10. I wanted to come. Where were you last Sunday? I wanted to come, but my mother would drive me. She was busy. Question is, busy with what? And what are you busy? What are you busy for? What could be more important than the Mass? What could be more important than the Mass? What? The Samsung Galaxy 4? It's so important. What is so important? Then you have to miss Mass. Although I was a bit in March, some few Sundays that I missed. In the hospital, there was no Mass. The TV, I searched all the channels, there was no Mass. But there were, in Caramas, there were two who gave us communion. Which is a good thing. That was the only time I missed Mass. To such as these, the children, you know the children, right? When Jesus speaks of children, we're not talking about those small creatures, no. We're also talking about, well, of course, literally, yes, but we're also talking about those who have young minds. If you remember what I told you before, sinning is bad. Causing others to sin is worse. The Bible says, if you cause someone to sin, it's better for you to tie your neck with a heavy rock and then you get dropped into the ocean. It's better. That's how serious it is. So, sinning is bad. Causing others to sin is worse. And what's the worst?
Rejecting.
Denying the sin. I'm not sinning. It's okay. That's the worst. And then next Sunday, John 16. It is the Holy Spirit who makes fully understood the truth revealed by Christ. Guess what? Gift of wisdom, gift of understanding. And of course, the Blessed Trinity. Okay? And very quickly, Bible study materials. If you look at the inspired articles, this one from Let money serve you. Don't let money rule over you. It's you are bound to learn big from this article. So you must read this, okay? And then, newness, harmony, and mission. This was his homily for the Feast of Pentecost. See, I'm giving you the very homily in the Vatican. So it's just like you were in the Mass. And quote for this week, the nation doesn't simply need what we have. It needs what we are. Does that make sense to you? America doesn't simply need what we have. Okay, I pay taxes. Okay, I obey the laws. I stop at the stop sign. Yes, the nation needs that. But the nation also needs what we are as a human being, as a with a soul. Apologetics, glimpses of conversion. This is a story of, just like Journey Home. You know Journey Home? This is a conversion story. So I recommend that you read this. And then there's another thing here, Pope Francis of Mass, fighting evil with meekness and humility. Okay? What is the bottom line fighting evil with meekness and humility? We remain sheep. Remember the sheep? You know, next week we will have, as usual, class here Thursday. But I will not have the Friday class next week. I will only have this class. Because I'm going to a retreat in Morristown for all the to be deacons, we will gather together.
Morristown?
Hmm?
For Aunt?
No, no, no. No. St. Mary's Abbey.
In Morristown?
In Morristown. We'll be there from Friday up to Saturday, up to Sunday. Stay in with spouses, it depends upon us. So we'll have a usual class on Thursday. Please come. Any question? Did you get anything from the lesson today? This 8 days is your treasure. I hope you value this. Because this last Sunday to next Sunday equips you. You see, the covering 3 years, you have the entire Bible, I promise you that. The entire Bible. You know, because of time, I had this out because there's supposed to be, I was supposed to show you a lot of this, but there's just too much to cover. That's why I'm not able to utilize this as much as I used to. Because we cover a lot. We're talking 8 days. Okay, let's pray. The Holy Spirit came, God the Father came, God the Son came. love everything that you love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We also pray for the gift of understanding, so we can truly comprehend all the hidden meanings in the sacred scripture as you intended it to be. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We especially lift up to you my one of ours, John Grimes, who appeared very lively last week, very strong, who participated in the entire class with his questions, including the fellowship, that you continue to bless him with more time on this earth as he delved into your sacred scripture as he wishes to serve you and know you and truly love you. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We also lift up to you ourselves that we will continue to come here and pursue these studies, because your word is truly inexhaustible and there will always be something new to learn. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We also pray for the poor souls in the state of purgatory, especially those who have no one praying for them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We also pray for Pope Francis and everyone who ministers to the church, especially Father Fuji, who I heard has been arrested again. Cover him with your most precious blood, Lord Jesus, as we pray for all those who minister to the church, coming from Pope Francis down to the last deacon, that you continue to guide them and mold them, use them, fill them, and that they will do only as you will. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
You may say your prayers now. Son.